interview.
Oh, good. Yeah. Oh, good.
Wait,
oh,
can
I please come with the order?
Wait.
Sure. Order is Elin, Ken, Pat, and Tim. That's good.
Great. Are we ready?
Yeah, you all set?
Yeah, it's on.
Elin, interview.
Thank you, Toastmasters. Well, the interview is one of the most impactful meetings you're going to have in your career. So what is an interview? In a room, an interviewer and an interviewee, they probably have very different mindsets. What will an interviewer think? You probably are going to prepare them for weeks, knowing that there's an interview going to come up. So Apple, for example, an interview is coming in a week. How long ahead do you start to plan what you are going to wear on that day?
Well, probably the day before. I mean, like, if that's the first interview in my life, I need to go shopping. But if, like, it's just down the road, I have several interviews, and I know what looks best on me.
And when do you decide what you are going to wear today?
Yesterday. Like, probably
okay.
This morning.
Yeah.
I'm, like, really casual dresser. I don't really care.
Okay. So for me, I would take probably a week before to start planning on what I'm going to wear. If it's too casual too boring, there are up to be in the middle. So what would an interviewee think? An interviewee, take me for example again. So if every day I have a lot of things to do, deadline and projects. If I open my calendar and see, oops, there is an interview, it means I have to do all kinds of things within an hour less. So it's just different mindset. I don't prepare for it. I don't have enough time for it. I probably will prepare the resume 1 minute ahead, take 10 seconds to read through it, and just go to that room. Well, over time, I do realize that interview is a very important process for me because I got to choose who I'm going to work with in the future. You need to be pleasant, productive, so a happy work life or be successful for the team and for the company later on. I got to learn that. So today I want to share with you the three stories that stand out, three interview stories that stand out in my career. A while ago, there is a guy who came to the office, was interviewing for an analyst position. He was 15 minutes late. He had my email address and he just did not choose to contact me. When he was here, HR told me, hey, he's finally here. I walk over him, he looked like all sweaty and obviously he's tired. He's like, I'm so sorry. The traffic on Michigan Avenue just horrible. I'm so sorry. It looks like he's running towards the office. So I'll give him a benefit of doubt, so I let it go to proceed with the interview. I took him to a room, to sit down in the room, give him a paper that is for a coding question. So he's supposed to finish that question in half an hour. I said to him, I will check with you in half an hour. Then I walk out to my desk. A few seconds later, I realized, holy crap, I printed out both the questions and the answer sheet. So I rushed to that room through the window of the door. I saw him was answering the question and looking at the answer sheet at the same time. So I opened the door. I asked him, did I accidentally give you the answer sheet at the same time? So instead of admitting it, he looked at me, he's like, oh yeah, this is the answer sheet. Sorry, I did not realize, here you go. Later, when we go through his answers, he answered most of the questions incorrectly, but only the first three questions is 100% correct. Well, obviously we did not proceed with this candidate. Later on, when I look back, what if he did something differently? What if he walked up to me, said, here is the answer sheet, sorry, accidentally gave it to me? That might change the story. Even he did not answer very well, but the fact that he turned the answer sheet to me speak about his moral, his work ethic. So that will make a difference. The second story is a girl. She is just graduating out of school. And I was reading her resume. She from top school, high GPA, looks like very smart, so I will talk to her. So on the interview day, she is very young, just out of school, looks nervous, right leg with a lot of feeling words. So I asked her, why did you apply this company? She looked at me and said, oh yes, that's a good question. This is a good location and I like shopping. After work, I go to a lot of stores on Michigan Avenue. I look at her, trying to prevent my job, like dropping. So I continued. Okay, tell me more about your school. What kind of class you take? What kind of project you enjoy doing? He goes, Oh yeah, the finance class. I like finance class because it's analytics. And it's not too hard. I don't like to think too hard. Well, this is an analytics position. We're looking for someone who enjoys the logical thinking process. Saying that she don't like to think too hard is a red flag. The third story was way back in China. I have to quit this job and come to the US. So I was helping the company to recruit for that position, and I posted online, got more than 100 resumes. So I don't even have time to click through and look for them. There is a girl, she did something different from all the other applicants. She called me. She actually called the company front desk and asked for my name. She said, hey, I read through your position. I actually read your work online. I really, really like this position. I enjoy it. I think it's a good fit. Can I talk to you? I send you a resume. I just want to make sure you receive it and to see if you have any questions. So I opened her resume. It's very average, just out of school. She don't have a lot of experience. But the fact that she called me do make a difference. She went through the interview. In the interview, I got to see her. She don't have a lot of experience, but she's very curious. To learn, showed like we call it intellectual curiosity, which is always a good sign. At the final round, there are two applicants that get to meet my boss. The other applicants, she is Oxford graduate PhD, have 2 years of relevant working experience. Then the other girl is her. So the fact that she got to play the same field as the Oxford graduate, it means something. It means that passion is very important. So the point of my story is that if you want to prepare for a successful interview, it's important to have punctuality, integrity, know what you want, and most importantly, passion.